targets today, as you're going to be marked pretty quickly if you get any sort of daylight off the front.
Oh, hey, Richard, good to see you. Our old friend from Levi's Grand Fondo. He is the best guy, Santa Rosa. You've got a real gentleman in your midst. Hey, Brad, as we watch the race right now, I got to say, when you look at it, we've hit two of the big names. This is not a field that was designed around field sprinters. This is an endurance event, and most of these riders would list their specialty as climbing, but here's the final name to throw into your box trifecta, Kirsten Wild. Absolutely a rider to be watching today on the high-tech team. As a matter of fact, I would put her in with the same kind of status, four-star status, as Corinne Rivera and Loretta Hansen.
Yeah, Wild comes into the day over 4 minutes down on the GC, so she won't be a threat when they start to see her and her high-tech products team coming to the front. I would imagine the GC teams will be happy to let them occupy that space.
The greatest of all time in our field, Mariana Voss, and Voss can sprint. No question, Mariana can do anything on a bicycle. And Brad, I would say, you know, you saw that crash, the video of her crashing a week ago. You realize that she was sprinting on the front of a bike race when that crash happened.
Yep.
So I would expect to see the multi-time Olympic gold medalist and world champion, Mariana Voss, certainly part of this conversation.
This makes sense why they would be bringing back the chase, as they're going to try and set up for Mariana Voss, or at least one of their sprinters on that Robo Live team, as obviously no one in the breakaway from that squad. So no big surprise there, but we'll get a better idea as they're starting to make their way in. Sounds like they are just a few K out from entering the circuits today.
Well, and you can expect old school fury when we have the riders on the circuit. Make your way to the barricade, Santa Rosa. There's a hurricane of pain coming through town.
Few things to watch. Look at the teams, look at the colors, and look at the riders on the front. That's our preview of the sprint. Santa Rosa, this is your women's pro peloton. Let's go. Well, look at the team directors in the cars behind, nervously watching these riders in the breakaway, trying to figure out what the strategy will be today. Do we keep this race together and let the sprinters go, or do we let someone attack? Do we try to get a gap going? We're going to find out here in 2.5 laps from now.
Well, so a little control being shown on the front right now. Two of the riders that were in our breakaway, we talked about Evelyn Steele. 4K, I would anticipate you're looking at a good 5 minutes per lap.
Actually,
that would be about the speed that they are racing at right now. All right, well, it certainly looks like we should expect a sprint here. We talk about those bonus seconds on the line. Even if Armstrong wins the stage and Garnier is locked out, not on the podium, she still won't give up the overall lead in the race. So at worst case scenario for Megan, it would just be a 2 second advantage. And Kristen Armstrong, their biggest danger woman, and Leah Thomas back in the conversation now. And she's another one of the riders on that 2016 team who is having a breakthrough year this year when you talk about Leah. And in fifth place coming into this stage, 47 seconds out is Corinne Rivera. So that's the overall battle that we're looking at. But Brad, it looks like today is going to be all about the stage win here in Santa Rosa.
Well, sounds like our breakaway, or field, I should say, a select group in the field making their way onto 4th Street now. So this will be the back side of the course before they come back onto 3rd Street for the finish line, which means we're about maybe a minute and a half, maybe 2 minutes from seeing the field.
Boy, I did not expect today to come down to a sprint, to tell you the truth, Brad. I thought it was going to be a small group of riders that we had coming to the line here. Talk to me about your thoughts.
Yeah, I think it was just because of how the breakaway shook out. If it weren't GC Riders in the breakaway, I think you're right. We would have seen a breakaway staying away to the line. Just
the break was too good, believe it or not.
No, absolutely. Right. Too many GC Riders in the break. But the conditions certainly played well to a breakaway with a little bit of rain falling on the women's peloton. We have cleared up now here in downtown Santa Rosa. But yeah, everything looked good for the breakaway on paper, but it never works out that way in real life.
What do you think about Scotty Lechuga's chances out of this field? Just looking down through our roster, Brad, for some riders to watch here today, Lechuga has proven to be a strong finisher. I mean, we really, outside of Loretta Hansen and Corinne Rivera, we really don't have, if you ask these riders, what is your specialty in cycling, they wouldn't be saying sprinting.
Yeah, there's about two pure sprinters and about 80 mediocre sprinters in the field. As everyone has to be a little, has to have a little bit of sprint in their legs. The question is, who's got the most?
It's just like saying a Ferrari is not a good around town car.
Right.
You know, I mean, it's obviously an awesome car, and these are the best riders in the world, but this is not their speciality. And that is a different type of rider that you're talking about when you've got the spirit back. This is it. We're looking at the front of the bike race. And it's a solo attack!
You can see the panic in the field as Winder went off the front in the U.S. national team kit. Ruth Winder is not the runner that you let go, especially with two laps of racing remaining. This was tailor-made for Ruth Winder.
Yeah, her team took a big hit on stage one. They're out there fighting now. Taylor Wiles on that U.S. national team squad. Brad, a little bit of a surprise, a cheeky move from Ruth Winder right now. Ruth Winder was born in the United Kingdom, but has lived in California for most of her life. Has been now, I don't even know, I guess she must hold an American passport if she's racing for our Olympic team.
Yeah, we should point out, Ruth, with just two teammates remaining in the race here at the Amgen Tour California. They started with six riders, but after a very difficult first 2 days, they're down to just Taylor Wiles, Kelly Catlin, and of course, Ruth Winder, our runner off the front for Team USA. This circuit right around 3K, and the speed's going to continue to increase. Dave, your average speed out here on a day like today, right around 28, 29 miles an hour?
At this point in the race, absolutely. I think that you're going to see the finishing sprint, if you had a radar gun on it, will be coming in right in the range of 36, 37 miles an hour, and that's what it's going to take to win here in Santa Rosa today. But you're right, Brad. Throughout the race, the average speed today will probably be in the 24-mile-an-hour range, but once they hit Santa Rosa here, things really start ramping up, and you can feel them ratcheting up the pace right now out there. I mean, Ruth Winder attacked with everything she had. She's all in on that move, and the peloton is just stalking her right now. So we'll see what is happening out on course when they come through Santa Rosa. We are counting on you to light it up, as we'll be sending them out with one final lap of racing here on stage three. 69 miles of racing has all come down to this. So that running time there on today's stage is 2 hours, 46 minutes, as they will be getting the bell here on the finish line. No shortage of bells here in Santa Rosa downtown today.
And we're going to ask for some help in ringing those bells when they come around to see one lap to go. And that's really where we're going to know who's trying to line this one up. The big thing, I'm going to be watching the teams grouping together, because the most well-organized team today heading into the final lap is going to have the best shot at winning the sprint. You cannot do it alone today. You absolutely need your teammates to win a sprint. They're going to be lining up what's called the lead out, where it's kind of like booster rockets sending a satellite into orbit. Each rider takes their turn, burns through all their energy on the front, and then ideally you drop your sprinter off right here on the finish line.
And here's two names to look at. Heather Fisher, who just won a stage of the Criterium in Gila. She's on the rally team. And along with her, I'm seeing Lauren Tamayo, our national Criterium champion as well for United Healthcare. And this is it, Santa Rosa, here we go. We've wound it up tight, and now it's down to one final lap of racing.
For the last 4K here at our Amgen Breakaway from Heart Disease Women's Race, empowered with Triumph. Watch the jerseys on the front. riders in the group, if they didn't make it onto the circuit in the group, they're not allowed to continue. Now, they will race on Sunday, but obviously not the full field. So that is your select group of riders at the front.
Well, as you take a look, Chloe Tiger, who's 18 years old, is a three-time world champion in her home country here in Richmond, Virginia. She won both the time trial and the road race against the best under 18 riders in the world. And you say, great, that's under 18. Well, about 3 months later, she showed up at the Elite World Track Championships in London, where she rode her way into an Elite World Championship with the American team. Chloe Tiger is the future of American cycling. Well, it's all on the line, but Brad, I'm going to say now, my pick, Corinne Rivera, United Healthcare.
Yeah, hard to argue against Rivera. I'm with you in the blue and white jersey for the 71-time national champion riding for United Healthcare, as we're now seeing our first advanced vehicles onto the finishing stretch. They're inside the last few K, onto the line, as they will line the sprint up. And again, it's all about patience, it's all about timing, and it's all about teamwork in Santa Rosa.
Well, our lead moto will clear the way. We're looking to that final corner. Brad, it's all on the line here in Santa Rosa. Here we go. Now there we go. Across the road. It's anyone's race. This will be a moto finish. Into the final 50 meters. It is going to be
animals.
The race with two laps to go, giving her all for USA Cycling here today. But it is Mariana Vos, the greatest cyclist of all time, winning here in Santa Rosa. Events are judged by the quality of their champions. The Amgen Tour of California is world class.
Unofficially, Mariana Vos, followed by Corinne Rivera and Emma Johansson, on the podium in third, as Rivera will find a silver medal today. Dave, we are going to be going straight to our podium presentation, so we're going to take a break to reset the stage as we get ready to crown our champion here at the Amgen Breakaway from Heart Disease Women's Race, empowered with SRAM. We'll have your winners up on the blocks in just a few minutes.